Hello, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a combination model, official, sort of, between Chi Mungus and Chi Sir Fangar from the summer 2014 LEGO Legends of Chima buildable action figure series. As of the time of the recording of this video, the official instructions for this model are not here. But by the time that you are watching this video, they may be here. And that'll be absolutely awesome for you, but it did absolutely no good for me. So I had to build a thing based on this picture. Usually I'm very, very, very confident in the end results when I do a build. And this time I'm not quite so much. I'm pretty sure that I got it to look just like the picture from this angle, but there are definitely some angles that cannot be seen from that picture whatsoever. So some of the kind of interior back up in there, some of the core structure may be a little bit different for adding things on, but the look, the overall look is definitely correct, and all the stuff that you see on the outside is right. So I figure this is still going to be good enough to show you what the thing looks like in more than just that single picture that you can see in the back of the instructions. So obviously this one is focusing on Mungus, so you've created here a larger version of Mungus, a really cheed up ultimate version of him, so to speak. And as with all of the other combination models from this particular series for summer 2014, I like this. I like what they've done with it. Now the secondary kind of trunk side tusks, if you will, are a little bit awkward. Would have worked out better if you could actually remove the normal tusks from that headpiece, but really doesn't bother me unless I really stare at it and think about it quite a lot. You end up not getting a long trunk with this character, but I think that's just fine. Now this does once again have a lot of bulk in the body. You've got some bulk going back inward, including the inclusion of a couple of kind of rib cage sort of elements there with what look like they could be bones off the side, and lots of bulk around the shoulders. It's something they continuously do throughout this series. I think that's nicely done. Asymmetrical with the legs down here. I think that works out just fine and kind of goes with the look of the original Chi Mungus figure, who had very different legs left to right. And the use of this large hand piece up here from Sir Fangar just kind of looks like it's a fuzzy bit, you know, some of the fur from a mammoth. I mean, it's white here. Maybe it's kind of covered in frost or something like that. I think it looks fine. I don't look at that as being a hand anymore. I don't look at that as being a claw when it's applied in this way. It just looks like a tuft of fur, maybe with some icicles hanging down. So I like that. Got kind of a double-bladed scythe for the weapon, and it looks not a whole lot of thickness to that or kind of menacing nature to its build, but I think it works out okay, especially considering that you have a nicer weapon over on this side. This is nicely done. It's kind of a crossbow sort of thing on a stick, if you will. You know, it's got a pretty long handle to it, but this is a nice little structure that they've done here to add some of the ice nature to this bow style of weapon, you know, actually arranged shooting weapon. So overall, and also stability is very good with this thing. There's a lot of weight up top. Also the weapons, though they are not too bulky, they have long handles on them. So as you turn things out and you move them, say you move this way out in front, you know, that's putting a lot of force or a lot of leverage on the model, and it's not going anywhere. It's got a good base to it with the help of these extra long little heels, that little extensions you can see down there at the bottom. Nice width with the cape. You know, it's pretty well splayed out, especially if you don't have the weapons back. You know, they can really open up and add to the feeling of bulk. This is the most awkward thing to me out of the armor pieces they put on there. I think just putting the full body armor, extra body armor piece on the shoulder that way, kind of sticking off the side. It's a little bit odd, a little empty under here, but it does kind of balance visually versus what you've got going on over here. So overall, I'm actually, once again, pretty pleased with this thing. I think they've made good use of the parts. There aren't a whole lot of parts left over after building this. And it looks like it was designed to be this way. You know, some of the older previous combination models have seemed like afterthoughts, like they really worked hard to try to figure out anything they could do with the parts, and oftentimes would go in strange directions. But this almost feels like it was designed to be this way from the start, and not like it was just a combination between two different sets. So I'm pretty happy with this one. Looking forward to hearing what other folks think about it. I believe this is the most massive of the combination models, but if it's not, it's pretty close. And yeah, please do leave your thoughts in a comment, and I'm gonna go build some more stuff and bring you some more videos. So I got work to do. I'll be talking to you again soon.